You ever ask yourself why Congress should get a special exemption from this law? All those in Congress who want out of this thing? Well, you know, that's a member of Congress asking the very same question. And now West Virginia Republican Congresswoman Shelley Moore Capito is refusing to accept that special treatment. And get this, she voted against this. But she does see it as a law of the land. And if Congress voted for this, it is the law. Congress should be part of this. Congresswoman, it's a novel concept. You know, trying to live by example here, but very few of your colleagues concur. Does that trouble you?
Well, I'm going to put some legislation in when we come back in September, and that's going to say that Congress cannot receive a subsidy for Obamacare. I think it's about fairness, and it's about holding lawmakers who made the law accountable. If it's good enough for the American public, it should be good enough for us to be treated the same way we would be if we were the general public. And under these provisions that the administration just put forward, we would get a special subsidy. And I don't think the American people want that, and I'm not going to accept it, and I'm going to encourage my colleagues to not accept it either and to make it so it's not the law of the land.
You know what's kind of interesting about your position is you were never a fan of this, but you seem to say, look, if it is the law of the land, unless we strike it down, we got to live with the pudding we're foisting on the American people, so be it. But a lot of your guys, particularly those who really champion this cause, don't want anything to do with it, which kind of scares me, Congresswoman, because I'm saying, well, you pushed for it, and now you're pushing on me, but you want nothing to do with it. Should I be worried?
I would be worried. I mean, we've already seen the president push back deadlines, make special provisions for businesses. We passed an exemption to the individual mandate to try to push back on that a couple of weeks ago that he doesn't find acceptable. So he's setting up a tiered system here where members of Congress and businesses and insurance companies have a special part of his marquee plan, yet the fairness of it is that everyday American citizens who are going into the exchanges are not going to be able to have access to that. I think that's fundamentally unfair. 7 million people are going to use their lose their employee-sponsored health care. It's a mess. I have voted to repeal it 40 times. It's a train wreck, as we've heard. But I think the last thing we need is Congress getting a subsidy to make it easier for us or for the rest of the Congress.
Amazing. Congresswoman, thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
Very good having you on the show.